Welcome, everybody. This is it. Over 50 Cup 16. Should be an exciting one, as always. Can't wait to see what's going on. And just as expected, we find the Grey Wolves and the Yellow Jackets here playing against one another. And what a way to finish the 16th season here of Over 50 Hockey here at the Ice Sports Forum in Brandon, Florida. I'm Angelo Pontello, bringing you all the live action here up in the Gondola Mezzanine area. And joining me in the booth, as always, Andy Townsend. Andy, any surprises here?
Well, not at all. I mean, again, you look at the way these teams were set up for this season. It was no doubt in my mind that the Grey Wolves were definitely going to be here, just the way the team was stacked and the players that they had.
Yellow Jackets, I'm not surprised that they're back either.
They're going to be looking to try to win this Over 50 Cup game to become the first Over 50 club to go for the three-peat. And if anybody couldn't be any happier or more excited on this Yellow Jackets squad, it's their keeper, Mark Rosengard. And definitely Mark Rosengard has definitely had his fair share of winning games, but this has to be bigger than, I wouldn't quite say bigger than life, because everybody's got work the next day, Andy, but you can tell this guy's gonna be pretty excited to make some history here. History will be handsome if Mark Rosengard can pull out a victory here for the Yellow Jackets. And of course, the other thing too is keep in mind, Mark Rosengard did not win his first Over 50 Cup until four seasons ago, and now suddenly he's just been on the rise of greatness. And you gotta tip your hat off to this guy. He's been through it all. He's been through the pain of losing seasons. He's now experiencing winning. He's winning opportunities here. And now with a team like the Yellow Jackets again, wouldn't it be something if they ended up winning this game? Now, speaking of the whole history, what mind you, y'all took the Grey Wolves here again. Looking at this resume, the way this team was built, they were destined to be in the Over 50 Cup this season. Again, with strong likes as Jim Thomas, Doug Radigan, and I gotta tell you, Radigan, again with his sensational rookie campaign, it's coming up here where he's got a chance to really show it off here. But of course, now with the absence of Jim Thomas, it's from what we've heard recently that he was not gonna be playing in this game, so it's gonna be up to Radigan to really step things up here for the Grey Wolves in addition to Matt Sharina and the rest of the game. And speaking of Over 50 Cup magic, one certain player in the very few people here has not won an Over 50 Cup at all just yet. John Maddalena, the longtime vet in this Over 50 Hockey League. Andy, do you see anything happening here? Well, as much as you want to see Mark Rosengard get the three-peat, you also want to see this man here who has been 15 seasons barren without a Stanley keg. You definitely want to see John Mudra, well, John Maddalena for that matter, win one here. But we'll see, it's gonna be an exciting game coming up.
And that'll conclude our pre-game talks, brought to you by Integral Hockey, the official hockey stick repair business of the Over 50 Hockey League. Coming to fix sticks, if you ever had a stick broken, it can be repaired anew with Integral Hockey. As they come to prepare, to repair your sticks, Integral Hockey is our sponsor for today's game. When we return, Over 50 Cup 16, it's the Grey Wolves and the Yellow Jackets taking it on here in the South Ring, here on the Pontello Broadcasting Network. Don't go away, we'll be right back. We're just moments away here from face-off to begin Over 50 Cup 16. Referees getting ready to be in position. Grey Wolves now making some final adjustments here. But for the Yellow Jackets, they're looking to try to keep things moving here.
Well, of course, the biggest thing as well, if you're the Yellow Jackets, is despite really recent success in the final few games, you always need to make sure that this is yet another game that they need to come across and play together hard as a team. For the Grey Wolves, you know, without Jim Thomas, this is going to really determine if they are the most superior team this season. And we'll begin the game there. Omar Chikwun now with the puck. They'll be taken away by Doug Radigan. We'll move this one up. Gets it away from Yellow Jacket players. Now back over to Sharina. Back over to Chikwun. Yellow Jackets on the move early here into the center ice.
Chikwun getting through a couple of Grey Wolf defenders, looking around the other way. Arnie Strader trying to hold him up. He does.
There might have been a little bit of a holding there. I'm not exactly sure, but luckily for Strader, referees didn't see it as a necessity to call him on it.
Buchholz firing the shot. Deflected by Radigan and out of the ring.
just like that, Yellow Jackets will make a quick lineup change here. Definitely don't want to take any chances. Grey Wolves will make a few substitutions as well. Checking in now for the Grey Wolves, you got Michael Levesque, Bill Tisch, and John Madalena all at the forward positions. And Levesque will take the faceoff against Jeff Toller. This one comes back over to Madalena at right wing. Trying to shoot this one out of the corner. Finds Levesque the other way. Setting it up, and instead it's going to be taken away by Reels. Toller gets a nice bounce pass over to an open Ira Lussman. Gorman back. And the pass is intercepted by Tisch. Tisch back out to Strader. Strader back to Tisch into the Yellow Jacket zone. Gets around a couple of players. No, Dominici strips it at the last second. Good defensive skills there by Pete Dominici. He's going to need to be making plays like that all game today. At the Yellow Jackets are going to be looking to hold up a nice defense. Gorman setting up the puck. He'll fire this one into the Yellow Jacket end. Back over to Reels. Looking for John Mudra. Now taken away by Lussman. Trying to set this one up to Toller. Got out of his reach. I didn't know exactly what Lussman was trying to do. I think he was getting a little too fancy with his passes and it backfired on him. Madalena's shot fired, knocked away by Rosengard. Here comes Dominici the other way. Lost control of the puck. And it comes back over to Madalena. The referee will quickly halt play. Looked like at first we thought it might have been an inadvertent whistle, but something must have came up. And now faceoff will take place by the blue line. That'll be Chacon and Sharina. Sharina now in the Yellow Jacket zone, covered by Chacon, looking back over to Radigan the other way. Taken away, and Chacon will handle onto the puck. And here comes Jim Pernice. Quick go back on defense. Pernice gets the pass back to Chacon, taken away now by Cristiano. Back over to Radigan, looking for Sharina just out of his reach. But Sharina will get to it first, working off of Paganella, now in the Yellow Jacket end. Sharina looking for the wraparound shot. And he'll come back over to Quicko. Stop now by Paganella, moving this one up, gets it out to Chacon. Finds Pernice on the right side. Back to Chacon. It's to Chacon in the deep slot. Sets up over to Pernice. Or Wyrcinski for that matter, gets it out to Quicko for the Grey Wolves. Stopped by Chacon. You okay there, Angelo? Well, I've been battling something all week today. Kind of surprised he's coming back right now. And Wyrcinski just puts it one into the Grey Wolves end. Not exactly sure what he was doing that time. Well, he had the opportunity to move it up, but I think the Yellow Jackets were just trying to continue to move the puck. Because again, they were looking for a lineup change, and the last thing they wanted to do was impede their lineup change with Wyrcinski moving the puck. Dominici's pass over to Toller, knocked away. And Toller, wild pass there. Madalena deflects it, and the Yellow Jackets are back the other way. Gorman intercepts it, will knock it back in the Yellow Jacket end. Finds Dominici, intercepted by Tisch again. Has to regroup. It'll be taken away now by Reels. Nice pass over to Nader, and he's got the Meza to work with. Two on one with Strader back. The Meza firing the shot, and it'll be saved by the keeper.
Michelangelo, this filling keeper for the Grey Wolves has done his job, especially after Carter had to unexpectedly leave the state.
Wow, Andy, I can't believe this cough's killing me now.
Are you sure you're all right, Angelo?
I don't know. I'm telling you, honestly, it's like I'm talking and suddenly before you know it, I got the chronic cough. This one to Buchholz.
Now in the deep slot, looking to set this one up. Back over to Radigan. Fired pass off of Rosengard. Ben Meza picks up the puck for the Yellow Jackets. Meza sets this one up. Back over to Radigan. Now it's to Wersinski, looking to set up to Meza. Lightning loose, got it the other way. Finds Nader. Back over to Meza again. Meza firing the shot, hits the post, knocked away. To Buchholz, looking for Radigan, punches this one up the middle. Now Paganella with the puck, struggling to keep it alive. Wow. This one goes for an icing call. Well, clearly now both teams have had their fair share of opportunities to get a goal in, but unfortunately they're just not able to punch it in. Now Grey Wolves will look to set it up. Shaquan and Levesque on the faceoff. Gorman fires on point. Kicked away by Rosengard. Rebound by Madalena. Deflected by Dominici. Gets it back over to Lussman. Lussman with the quick pass to Shaquan just out of his reach. Shaquan over to Reels. Back to Lussman. Fires just outside the corner, back over to Chacon. Deflected by Schrader. Back over to Lussman, flips the shot, and it'll be saved again.
And of course, you're not going to get a lot of opportunities like that if you're Ira Lussman, where nobody's around you and you have more opportunity to try to
take a finesse shot at that.
Vic. Trying to get that shot off. Icing call made, and this will be brought back into the Grey Wolf zone. Toler trying to take this one himself and come back to Wersinski. Back over to Quicko. Missed shot that time. It'll be taken up by Whitlock. Gets around Paganella. Taken by worse than Skiba. Wersinski in the deep slot. This one comes back over to Toler on the left side. We'll fire the shot, and it'll be a glove hand save.
We got a wire to low glove side.
And we're back here, folks, getting ready to start the second period. We won't apologize about the audio difficulties. Cristiano and Toler on the face-off. This will come back over to Wyrcinski. This one comes back to Demeza. Looking quickly to work off the right side. This will get knocked out. From Wyrcinski back to Toler. This one gets knocked away by Cristiano. Quico trying to move this one up quickly. It's 3-on-2. Quico will now look to try to get some star action of his own. Takes it back by Toler to a wide open Lussman. Trying to move this one up to Paganella. This one gets knocked out by Cristiano. Back the other way to Whitlock. Sharina to Radigan, firing the shot, rebound by Sharina. This one working quickly, it'll be Toler that takes it away. Back over to Cristiano, now back to Quico. for Murasinski. Quickly with the puck. Now back to Radigan. Fires a shot. Deflected off of Rosengard. Back to Sharina. This one gets to Buchholz in the corner. Fired by Whitlock. Knocked out by Rosengard. Rosengard again knocks it away. And Mudrow will clear it out. And it's open net off the balance. And that's going to be a net off the goal. That's got to be some kind of penalty coming up there. Ira Lussman knocks the net off balance, and that's got to count for something, Andy. I've never seen this before, but that really has to count for something. And if these referees botch the call right here, that could be detrimental. For a second, it might have been Ira Lussman that might have done the intentional game, and now referee calls it up.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
And a high sticking is the official call on Steve Gorman. And if that doesn't get your blood boiling, I don't know what will. And the puck will get cleared out. And after all that we've been seeing right now, Angelo, it is huge. After getting this one knocked away. This one to Dominici. Finds Chiquan over the middle, working off a 5-on-3, and this one shoots right into the keeper for the save. And the Yellow Jackets will make a few substitutions, but will elect to keep Chiquan in there as he takes the faceoff against Radigan. This one back over to Demeza. Lightning Lou with the setup on point to Chiquan. Back passes it, misses Nader. You can't get too fancy, you just have to focus on putting it in the net. Back to Dominici. We'll move this one up. Pass it back to Reels. Reels looking for options. Gets it out to Nader in the corner. Dominici double covered by Grey Wolves. Knocked it away by Levesque. This one back over to Reels. Shoots it into Sharina. Back to Nader in the corner. Bounces away from Radigan, almost into Chiquan. Demeza regrouping. We'll take this one in the Grey Wolves zone. Off to the right side. And this one bounces away. Paganello with the second hand shot knocked away. Radigan will get this one away. Hits the referee in the back. Ten seconds on the 5-on-3 as a kick save gets knocked out. Back over to Demeza looking for the setup. Gets around the players and he's in! And who would have thought the player that thought was to be on IR and just reactivated a week ago would put the first goal in the net for over 50 Cup 16, and it bounces off the keeper, and with 9 seconds to go on the power play,
It is 1-0 Yellow Jackets with 7:48. And now there's a little bit of confusion on the Grey Wolf bench as to trying to get five people, but we still, they still have four players for another 5 seconds until we get back to even strength. This one gets back to Quicko, looking for options. Back to Wersinski, finds Lussman. Misses Mudra. Gets over to Tisch. And Lussman intercepts it. Gets around a couple of Grey Wolf players, knocked out by Whitlock. Paganella will take this one himself, but it's an offsides call. Brian Vick coming out at just the wrong time. He should have came out the other way instead. Well, that's what happens when you have a big breakaway there. You have to be a little bit more careful on how you approach coming out of the bench. Especially when Paganella decides to take off. Shireen now back over to Dominici.
Oh, he trapped it.
And nice and calls been made. Faceoff taken, Radigan with a shot. Back over to Vic. And Gorman will flip this one back into the Yellow Jacket zone. Dominici with a pass out to Toler has got him. And this one bounces off the keeper, still in the Grey Wolf zone. Back to Strader. From Toler. Out to Vic. Knocked away. Shot again. Back to Dominici. Just misses an opportunity for a 2-0 lead just off the outside of the keeper. And this one now will be taken up by Radigan with Sharina. Radigan fires a shot. Not exactly sure why he took that shot in the first place. And Sharina's rebound completely misses the net. You can see the Grey Wolves are now starting to play desperate here, and it's only 1-0. I mean, take your time, boys. There's lots of hockey left to be played. Gorman will take this one himself with only Dominici back. And Gorman will fire a shot on the outside corner. This one back over to Dominici.
Come on, hit the puck!
Gets it over to an open Vic. And now misses at the coin. Out the corner, sets up the Paganella just on the outskirts of the net. Strader in his own end. Meets Madalena, flips it high. Bounces off the red part of the Yellow Jacket bench. And comes back to play, but referees will halt. And with 4:52 to go in the second period, it is still a 1-0 Yellow Jacket goal, thanks to a goal made by Demeza as he gets it off just the keeper's feet. And I gotta tell you, Angelo, if that is how this game goes, where it ends up being a 1-0 Yellow Jacket victory because of that, I don't know, the Grey Wolves may be looking at themselves and figuring they really could have had an opportunity to win over 50 Cup 16. Demeza gets it around Tisch. Gets around Quicko. Demeza firing the shot, goes high. Rebound taken by Radigan. He'll move this one up with Bill Tisch. And now he's got Whitlock to work with. Two back for the Yellow Jackets as this shot's fired. Comes back over to Paganella. From Demeza, misses trick one. Now comes back over to Quicko. Taken away by Demeza. Working around Sharina. Tips it back over to Nader, firing the shot, shoots it into Quicko. The puck slides all the way back to Rosengard. It'll now be moved up from Demeza to Chiquan on the left side. And it'll be stripped loose back over to Demeza. Picked up by Reels. Shot taken. Rebound picked up by Quicko. Off the boards, misses Reels, taken by Chiquan. Sets up to Dominici. Pass deflected and knocked out by Buchholz. Madalena. His pass reversed. Now comes back over to Sharina. Reverses traction. Shot fired. And it'll be knocked away. This puck's going to slide all the way back in the Grey Wolf end. Keeper signaling ice and call. No call will be made there. Puck now to Dominici. 3 minutes to go in this second. Strader gets it to Radigan. Will work with Levesque. And Radigan fires the shot himself. Reels pass will be more like a clearance, and this one goes all the way into the Grey Wolf end. Taken up by Strader to Gorman. Off the boards just out of Tish's reach. Now will be back over to Paganella. Puck comes up to Toler, trying to make a move around Strader. Still alive, will fire the shot, knocked away. Toler gets his own rebound, sets it up to Paganella. Fires back the other way to an open John Mudra, lost beating. And at that mid-Angelo for a guy who scored 5 goals and 3 assists since week 9. Mudra is really laxing today. Puck fired back the other way. Rosengard will dive on this one for the save. Grey Wolves just inches away from trying to tie this one up. And now faceoff takes place deep in the Yellow Jacket zone. Levesque versus Chiquan on the faceoff. Comes back from Levesque looking for Radigan. Bernice trying to get it through. Radigan just spins around getting the shot off, but just misses Rosengard. This one coming off the boards. Back to Quicko. Whitlock with the shot fired. Shoots it right into Chiquan. We'll get this one out to Bernice. And he ends up clearing this one away. Radigan for the Grey Wolves will take it. Chiquan misses it. Here comes Levesque. And he's got Tisch and Whitlock. 3-on-2. Back the other way and gives it up to Paganella. Not a smart pass there by the Grey Wolves. They have to do a little bit better controlling the puck. Chiquan versus Quicko. Makes a deep move one way around the other way. Looking for another finesse shot. And Quicko dives on it and will stop play. They'll hold off. Oh, and I think the referees are going to award Chiquan the goal. I think that's what the call is right now. I thought we might have seen something different. No, that wasn't. They're just going to relocate the puck that time.
Yeah, I was about to say, I was pretty sure that it was the keeper and Quicko diving down. And we've seen crazier callings from these officials before. So, I mean, you never know.
Puck gets open to Sharina, only Dominici back. Sharina firing the shot, punched out by Rosengard. Deflected high. Sharina back to the puck.
finds Buchholz. Knocked out Chirino. Working off of Demeza. Comes from Buchholz, taken away by Dominici. And he barely gets this one away from a sliding Schrader. Slipped and fall by Gormley. Here comes Dominici. Fires a shot, deflected off of the keeper. Oh, unreal is that. How unreal is that, Andy? And that's how time expires at the last second. That is what you call divine intervention. Steve Gorman slipping and falling like that. You rarely see him make a blunder like that. And Dominici should have made that shot. I'm telling you, as soon as Gorman fell with a 3-0, if you're the Yellow Jackets, it should be 2-0 right now. And for them not to capitalize on that, that's saving grace from the gray, for the Grey Wolves. An exciting final seconds at that with that second intermission. And because of saving grace, it is still a 1-0 Yellow Jacket game heading into the final period. But it is going to come down to the final 12 minutes of this game to see who's taking home over 50 Cup 16. We'll take a quick break here. Yellow Jackets trying to hang on for their first ever three-peat and over 50 Hockey's first ever three-peat. When we return, you are watching Over 50 Cup 16 on the Fontella Broadcasting Network. When we return.
Way to hustle, Lou.
Nice try to pick that up in the corner, buddy.
And Michael Levesque will take the faceoff against Chiquan for the third and final period. Chiquan feeds it out to Demez on the left side, taking the shot. Chiquan trying to get that rebound. And Levesque will skate quickly. He's got Radigan to work with. He'll fire the shot himself to the right side. And when are these Grey Wolves going to learn that you're not going to score on Rosengard through individual performance? Once again, you had Doug Radigan there to help you out, and Michael Levesque should have made that shot, but now it's the Yellow Jackets the other way. Bouncing forward, and just enough for the keeper to fall on this one for the save. Now with the lineup change, Yellow Jackets now will look to try to extend their lead if they can play their cards right with 11:22 to go. Back is the Buchholz. Stopped by Wersinski. Struggling with Tisch. And this one comes back to Quicko for the Grey Wolves. Back out to Wersinski. Nice clean pass to Demez on point. And the pass from Demez is too strong. Buchholz trying to clear this one out. He does. Paganella. Working off of Buchholz, and Buchholz puts it right in front. Bad handling by Paganella. Buchholz fires a shot, puts it through. Tom Buchholz with the one-timer shot off of Paganella error, and this game is back all tied up at one. And see, that's where if you're studying players all time long, it should have been better puck handling by Steve Paganella, but as soon as he was trying to do Mickey footwork, Tom Buchholz puts his stick there, and it was nothing but a potential air shot there. And for Mark Rosengard, the keeper, he just was not prepared. Oh boy, and another slash there that time. No call by the referees. They got to get in hand because this is where things start to get serious. This one comes back over to Toller. Back to Toller. And Radigan can move this one across. Schrader with the puck. It'll be taken away by Lussman and poked out by Gorman. Here comes Radigan the other way. Stopped by Dominici. This one comes back over to Levesque. Back to Radigan. Lussman trying to set this one up, but it'll be stopped by Schrader. And now we'll fight for the puck. from Toller. It'll come back to Reels. Grey Wolves trying to make a line of change in the process. They've done a good job to hold them off defensively. Strader fighting for the puck, and this one comes back around to Lustman. Hanging on with the puck. And this one will come back over to Worsinski. Trying to control the puck. Quicko now to Vic. Vic back to Chacon into the deep slot. Shot taken. Just off the backside of the keeper. Now comes back over to Pacanella. Firing shot deflected off of Madalena into the hands of Cristiano. Pacanella trying to get to the puck. And he will dump this one in to the Grey Wolf end. Taken by Chacon. Working off of Cristiano. Chacon will regroup. Gets this pass off to Pacanella. Now will fire the shot. Shoots it right into Whitlock for the Grey Wolves. From Chacon back to Worsinski. Will fire the shot. Bouncing puck. Pernice trying to locate the puck.
Oh, he's a little rock there.
Stopped by Whitlock, now taken by Cristiano with a long pass just out of the reach of Tisch, trying to escape back for it, and is defended well by Worsinski.
Your turn, Steve.
Puck to Dominici, deflected by Radigan, back in Dominici's possession. Gets it just out of Chacon's reach, and now will be taken away by Radigan. Off the boards. It'll be an offsides call.
Come on, Lou, keep it rolling.
7:27 to go in this game, still tied up at one. And it'll be Mike Levesque and Jeff Toller at it at the faceoff. This one coming back over to Gorman. He's gonna find Strader slowly moving this puck up just past Lightning Lou, and this one's gonna get back to Dominici. Off the boards pass, complete to Nader. Finds Toller on the right side, heading into the Grey Wolf zone. Back over to Demeza. Winding up his shot, deflected one way. Rebound by Demeza, picking up his own. And will be stopped by the keeper again.
For the save.
And now you can start to tell that both teams are getting very tired here. It's going to really come down to who's going to have the last must of energy, and even switching things up on the lines is not going to be enough. It's going to have to be a hard effort push by some of the better players on his teams. Nader with the pass out to Toller, trying to get the shot off, and he spins and falls. He'll get knocked away. Grey Wolves now with the puck.
And Gorman trying to clear this one out will be stopped by Worsinski. We'll get this one back over to Pacanella. Intercepted by Radigan, firing the shot. To Worsinski, back to Nader, stopped by Radigan. Radigan off the left side, he'll fire the shot himself, and this one goes high. Demeza looking for Nader, intercepted by Gorman, he'll take this one in. Working off of Demeza. Shot fired the other way. This one's going to come back out all the way to Strader. Finds Chacon. Off the left side, judging his shot. It'll get knocked away. Shot taken by Nader, deflected by Strader, and here he comes the other way. Arnie Strader gets around Reels, and here comes Cristiano trying to get this one out. Gets around Rosengard, big opportunity, knocked away. And that could have been a Yellow Jacket gaffe. And this one's gonna get knocked back by Strader. And he'll regroup. finds the pass over to Buchholz.
This one gets out to an open Cristiano. Will fire the shot himself as he's tagged up by Lussman. This one gets over to Rios.
And I think there might be a too many men on the ice coming up here on the Yellow Jackets. That would be huge. And I think that's what's going to be happening here. Oh, if they end up putting somebody in the box, this game could be turned right here with 4:59 to go in the game. Let's see what the calling is. It looked like the Yellow Jackets were doing fine, but maybe one of the referees noticed they were taking just a little bit too long to get on the bench. And if that's the case, it'll be too many men on the ice, and the Grey Wolves will have a power play opportunity late in this game. And now he's trying to explain this one over to Toller.
I could not understand anything of what just happened right there, Angelo. I ought to be quite honest. It went from too many men to the ice to now somebody who wasn't even on the ice at all serving the penalty. The only thing they got right was the too many men call. This one gets out to Wyrcinski, and he will clear this one out. This will come back over to Whitlock. Looking for Radigan. And Paganella will clear this one out again. Quicko off the boards. Getting around the other way. Stopped by Quicko. Shoots it right into Toller. Gets over to Whitlock. Back to Radigan, taking a lot of time.
All the way down!
He saw it, send it back!
Play will be halted. Both teams will now take face-off right by the Yellow Jacket blue line. It'll be even strength once we reach 3 minutes flat, as Radigan gets this pass over to Quicko. Quicko looking for Buchholz has got him. Shot attempt there completely misses the net, rebounded by Radigan. And he takes a wild shot off to the left side. Quicko barely able to get to it. Now it's Dominici. Back to Radigan. Trying to keep this one alive. And gets out to Dominici. Finds Chaquan, and it's now 2-on-1 for the Yellow Jackets. Chaquan looking for the deep move, now fires to Demeza the other way, looking for the back pass opportunity, sliding through, and it's a save there by Whitlock's stick, and keeps this game alive with 3:05 to go. That is what you call highlight defensive plays, and that's the kind of plays you'll see here in over 50 cups. It's just defensive efforts like that when it's a championship game and everything's on the line. You start to see a little bit more of a push here from the players, even if they all are tired. Demeza looking for the open pass, hits off of Tish. Nader will still get to the puck. Bounced off of Quicko, now taken away by Toller. Back the other way, Buckles trying to get to it. Over to Wyrcinski, 2:26 to go. Wyrcinski off the left side trying to take the shot, just not enough curve on the net. And this one will get cleared out the other way. Paganella will watch this one go back, and it'll be an icing call.
with 2:12 to go. Faceoff will take place now deep in the Grey Wolves' zone. On the faceoff, this one goes back to Dominici. Sets up to Reels. Shot fired from Sharina. Gets out to Dominici. Looking to regroup. From Lussman. Getting out to Gorman in his own end. Sharina working closely off of Reels, just out of Cristiano's reach. Tish trying to skate this one up. Lussman's pass complete out to Mudra. And just lost control of the puck. Tish will get this one away. Now back over to Rios again. Toller with the puck. Gets around Strader. Will fire the shot. Just out of his reach now, Dominici picks up the rebound. And this one will come back. Off the boards. Now to Tish. Looking for Radigan. Back to Radigan, open opportunity here. Looking to take the shot, knocked down by Rosengard. Off the boards by Sharina. And this one, Chacon gets a piece of it, gets around Strader, and it's a big breakaway opportunity. Cuts back, two defenders back, and Strader gets in there trying to hold off Chacon. He does! That's a good defensive effort there by Strader. Chacon just taking too much time with the puck. And it backfires on the Yellow Jackets. And a long shot taken there that time will come down and be saved by the keeper. And with 40.2 seconds to go, it really is going to come down to the final seconds. Well, perhaps not. I mean, we might be seeing an overtime period here, the first ever in an over 50 cup game. So we'll see. I mean, it's, you never know. This is the exciting moments where it's bound to happen. So Chacon's ready to take the faceoff against Mike Levesque. But I think there's a timeout that's been called by the Yellow Jackets, and they're going to think things over here. Currently, their momentum's in their hands, but you never know what we could see next. We'll take a quick break here ourselves. 1-1 is the score. Lightning Lou in the first period with his goal, and then Tom Buchholz's one-timer here in the third period. It will come down to the final moments here. When we return, you're watching Over 50 Cup 16 on the Pontello Broadcasting Network. Here, folks, to the iSports Forum for Over 50 Cup 16. 1-1 is a score, 40.2 seconds left in regulation. It's Chacon and Levesque on the faceoff. Quicko trying to get this one out of his own zone. Off of Sharina, now off to Levesque, working back against Paganella. Puck sitting, Wyrcinski looking for the pass, finds Chacon. 3-on-2. Chacon firing the shot, misses the net. Nader with the rebound. Firing shot the other way. And Levesque trying to get to the shot, but he slips and falls. This one comes over to Paganella. He'll hold on to the puck, and we got ourselves an overtime period coming up. Back over to Chacon. Last seconds. This one bounces up for the save. And so 3 periods is not enough. We head to 3-on-3 overtime hockey, and what better way, Andy, to finish off this game or to decide who's gonna be taking home that over 50 Stanley keg? Well, this is it. I mean, it really comes down to this. Will John Maddalena get his first Stanley keg, or will the Yellow Jackets become the first over 50 team to go for the three-peat? All this and more, we'll take a quick break here. When we return, it is Grey Wolves 1, Yellow Jackets 1 on the Pontello Broadcasting Network.
back here, folks, just moments away from starting the overtime period. And Andy, what do you expect us to see here?
Well, definitely, if I'm the Yellow Jacket, you got to go with Omar Chikwan, Rick Nader, and Jeff Toller as your first line with this 3-on-3. Either that, or if you're looking at it from a traditional two forwards, one defenseman standpoint, then I'd say Chikwan, Nader, and maybe Dominici in the back. But you have to be smart. And if I'm the Grey Wolves, I definitely think you have to put Levesque and Sharina together. You know, from what we've seen so far, it seems like that's the best chance for the Grey Wolves to pull off some magic. And then maybe have Gorman as your defense for security purposes. But
where it's supposed to be.
With the way these defensemen are for the Grey Wolves, you have to have Steve Gorman out there the majority of this 3-on-3 time, because you need a secured defenseman that can come out there and make plays. And it looks like they're going to start off with Sharina, Doug Radigan, and Steve Gorman. And they'll have Jeff Toller, Rick Nader, and Dominici as the other 3-on-3. I'm not exactly sure if this is going to be a good choice for the Grey Wolves. Doug Radigan has been playing by himself all game today, and he's always thinking shoot first versus pass things off. Maybe this will give him an outlet opportunity here, but we'll find out. Gorman moving the puck up. Flips this one high. This one comes out to Nader. Back over to Radigan. Finds Sharina. Only Dominici back. From Sharina, looking for Radigan, just misses his shot opportunity. Radigan, back over to Gorman. Will fire the shot, and Rosengard deflects it high. That'll halt play. And now, of course, smart play there. They're going to bring out Demeza and Chikwan. And if I'm the Grey Wolves, I definitely need to be thinking more defense than trying to really score here. Well, I mean, you can at this point, because if you take a chance here and Omar Chikwan breaks free, chances are the Yellow Jackets are coming away with the Stanley Cup. Chikwan's pass gets it off to Demeza. And Buckles keeps it within play, knocks this one away. Back to Whitlock. Finds Buckles. From Demeza off the boards, here comes Chikwan on the left side. Working around the other way. And here comes Levesque. Gets around Steve Gorman, open opportunity. Here comes Mike Levesque off the left side. Looking to set this one around, just misses outside the corner. Rebounded by Whitlock, now back to Sharina. Off the boards, out to Whitlock. Sets up the other way, firing shot just off the outskirts for Levesque. Demeza trying to move this one up quickly, and now it's back by Sharina. To Whitlock. Deflected off by Chikwan. Chikwan taking a lot of time here. And he'll fire this pass out to Demeza. They'll take their time. Kicked away by Radigan. Gets a move around Wersinski. Radigan on the left side will fire the shot, puts it through. The rookie delivers for the Grey Wolves, and they are the Stanley Cup champs. And it does pay off for the Grey Wolves that time. Just a nice shot comes around. Wersinski just wasn't able to deliver the deflection there off of Radigan. Unreal is that. That's just, they're really good shot there by Radigan for the Grey Wolves. They really can't deliver. And Mark Rosengard and the Yellow Jackets just one goal away from becoming the first three-peat team in this over 50 club. Just fell short here. Oh, you gotta be feeling for them. Wow. Let this one soak in, Andy. Probably the game that we've seen. And quite frankly, Angelo, I mean, from what we've seen, and you've come up with the predictions all week, this was a good game, but for this Grey Wolf team, they end up delivering big time. And Doug Radigan really did step up overall in this game, just like we said in the pregame, that he had to do if the Grey Wolves were gonna win this one, and he sure did.
We'll be right back as we come down there to film the presentation of the trophy. But the Grey Wolves will take this one home. 2-1 is your final score where we return. This is Over 50 Cup 16 on the Fontella Broadcasting Network.
Here we are in the dress room. Larry Sincato. Larry, what kind of beer do you drink after the game?
Man, after I'm working a hard game, I drink Bud Light. And that's the beer champion.
What do you mean after? You drink it before the game?
No, I drink Molson before.
There he comes out. Miller Light.
Bud Light, beer champion. Tom Buchholz, extraordinaire. Tom, what do you drink after the game?
Miller Light. I brought it from the Grey Wolves.
Miller Light, beer of champions.
Tastes great.
He calls it his white lightning.
And welcome back here, folks. If you're just tuning in, Grey Wolves capping off of a game-winning shootout goal made by Doug Radigan. And there you have it, the champs for the fall 2016 season. And what a game it has been. All these men fighting hard. And then it came down to the final moments, and they got the job done there.
You've never been.
And of course, we got to give a little bit of our love to our part-time PBN broadcaster, Randy Cristiano, finally coming away.
What a great game. Missed a couple weeks. It's great to be back. How about that goal by Dougie?
I got to admit, that's been something that everybody's been quite excited about. What a goal there. But Randy, how does it feel to actually be a champion again?
Oh, it's been so long, I've forgotten what it was like. But it's good. Feels real good. It's a great season for everybody. I'm glad I just got to make it back for the last game.
Absolutely. Well, go celebrate this one, Randy. Again, congratulations to you guys.
Yeah, we won.
Between filling in for John Cotter and the thing they've rolled, and we got to admit, John, we have to take a moment of your time. This is it. I got to tell you, you've waited, what, 15, 16 seasons?
After 27 years of the
He finally gets his first Stanley keg, getting the victory, breaking what everybody thought was the Madalena curse, but he finally got it done here. John, tell me how you feel right now.
It's great. It's great. Great group of guys, man. Good group of guys, but we got the best announcer in all of sport. Watch out for that guy.
Absolutely, for sure. And Tom Buchholz coming with the goal to tie things up in regulation with a one-timer shot. And he is just as happy for this over 50 keg. And of course, Arnie Strader as well.
Sorry I missed the meeting on short notice, but I'll be there next weekend.
That's all good. And on that note, we gotta wrap it up here. Good to see everybody again. Over 50 Cup 16. It goes to the Grey Wolves. Final score, Grey Wolves 2, Yellow Jackets 1 off of a Doug Radigan game-winning goal there. And we hope to see everybody back again next season in just a couple of weeks. Until then, for Andy Townsend, I'm Angelo Fontello saying so long, good night. We hope everybody has a blessed evening. Take care, everybody. We will see you back here in a couple of weeks.